Hello, welcome to NETVN channel. In this video I will show you how to build a private cloud server on VMware Hypervisor. I will increase my cloud storage by adding a separate physical hard drive. Also I will configure connection to cloud storage without port forwarding on router. I have prepared a 500 GB hard drive for my private cloud. Hope you have a hard drive with a larger capacity for your cloud storage, like 4 TB for example. On Windows, check to see if the computer has detected a new physical hard drive. The hypervisor used in this video is VMware Workstation Player. So if you want to add a physical hard drive to the VMware virtual machine, you need to delete all the existing partitions. You put the physical hard drive in the unallocated state. To add a physical hard drive to a VMware virtual machine, you must open the VMware hypervisor with administrative privileges. Now you create a new virtual machine, Ubuntu. The operating system used in this video is Ubuntu Server. So that you do not have to wait long, I have downloaded the ISO file to install the Ubuntu Server operating system on your computer. Next, you edit the virtual machine to fit the purpose of this video. You remove the default virtual hard drive of the virtual machine. You configure the network as a bridge so other computers can connect to your private cloud. Next, you add a physical hard drive to your virtual machine. Add hard disk SATA. Use a physical disk. The physical hard drive for the virtual machine is physical disk 1. Physical disk 0 is the hard disk running the Windows operating system. Physical disk 1 corresponds to disk 1 in the disk management of the Windows operating system. Our virtual machine already has a physical hard drive. The next thing is to install the Ubuntu Server operating system for it. You start the virtual machine and start the installation. You choose the language that is right for you, and I will choose the language as English. I recommend that you assign a static IP address to the virtual machine. Virtual machine with IP address is very convenient for next steps. Like here I assign IP address 10.11.32.184 to Ubuntu Server virtual machine. With the hard disk you leave as default, it's quite complicated for a novice to the Ubuntu Server operating system. Next you will be asked to create an admin account, you usually write it down to use in the next steps. Don't forget to enable OpenShift Server, it will help you to connect to Ubuntu Server from physical computer. After the preparation steps, the installation will begin. It will take about 10 minutes to complete the Ubuntu Server OS installation. You press Enter key to continue. So I have installed the Ubuntu Server operating system on the virtual machine. To check the IP address of the virtual machine, I use the command hostname strike through uppercase letter I. From the physical computer, I connect to the virtual machine using SSH. You open a command prompt and use SSH to connect to the virtual machine Ubuntu Server. The command used is SSH NetAt 10.11.bahai.184. You enter the admin password when prompted. The admin username and password is generated when you install the Ubuntu Server operating system on the virtual machine. To build private cloud storage, Nextcloud is a great choice. Before installing Nextcloud, you should update and upgrade the Ubuntu Server operating system. You update with the command sudo apt update. Next you upgrade with the command sudo apt upgrade. To install Nextcloud on Ubuntu Server, you use the command sudo snap install Nextcloud. You only need this one command to install Nextcloud on Ubuntu. If you forgot the IP address of the Ubuntu Server, then you use the command hostname strike through uppercase letter I. Next, open any browser and enter the IP address of the virtual machine to configure Nextcloud. You will be asked to create an admin account for Nextcloud. You write this account down to use in the next steps. Nextcloud suggests you to install some software. But so you don't have to wait long, I won't install those softwares. You can install the software for Nextcloud after building the cloud storage server. Let's check how much is our cloud storage. Surprised with a 500 GB hard drive, I only have 85 GB of cloud storage. Don't worry, you need to use the following commands to get maximum capacity for your cloud. You reopen the command window and use the following commands. LV extend strike through L plus 100% free slash dev slash Ubuntu strike through VG slash Ubuntu strike through LV. One more command. Resize 2fs slash dev slash mapper slash Ubuntu strike through VG strike through Ubuntu strike through LV. You refresh your browser and check your cloud storage again. Hooray, the storage has changed to 429 GB. If your hard disk has a larger capacity, it will be much larger. But as you can see, you can only access Nextcloud from your local network. So what to do if you want to access Nextcloud from the internet? First of all, you enable HTTPS for Nextcloud. Sudo nextcloud.enable strike through HTTPS self-signed. Refresh your web browser and you should see HTTPS in the address bar. We try to upload a file to see if there is an error or not. So the file is uploaded successfully and there are no errors. By default, Nextcloud only allows computers in the local network to access it. So you need to edit the file config.php. Sudo nano slash var slash snap slash nextcloud slash current slash nextcloud slash config.php. You scroll down and find the line like I'm highlighting. You replace the IP address with the star character. This way you allow access to Nextcloud from anywhere. Don't forget to save your changes to config.php. Use the key combination CTRLX to exit. Press the Y key to agree to the changes. In this part, I will show you how to access Nextcloud without forwarding ports on router. To do that, I use grok. First, you install grok with the command sudo snap install grok. You just need to register a free account of grok. Grok has a free and paid version. In this video, I use the free version. Next command helps you to connect to your grok account. You just need to copy and paste the command to succeed. The last command is grok http 443. This is the domain name to access your cloud. Let's try it. So you can access your Nextcloud without forwarding ports on the router. A hard to remember domain name for the free grok plan. To get a custom domain name, you should consider using a paid plan. You can also use port forwarding on your router and register a free .conf domain name to access Nextcloud from the internet. This method is suitable if you can't access the router but still want to access Nextcloud from the internet. Next, I will try on my phone and see the results. I have the Nextcloud app pre-installed on my phone. I will connect to Nextcloud with the domain name I got in the previous step. Thanks for watching. If it's helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe. I will upload 2 photos to my private cloud. As you can see, Nextcloud works fine.